When it comes to suspension design for a competition car, the unequal length double wishbone is undoubtedly the best option. It gives the suspension designer a lot of freedom, particularly in choosing things such as camber curve, as well as controlling aspects such as the bump steer. However, it doesn't come without its downsides. It is a more complex system than the likes of the MacPherson strut that we see on the front of a lot of production road cars. In particular, there are a lot more suspension bushes, and these of course can wear over time, and this requires a lot more maintenance. When it comes to bushing materials, there are a few options, and the ultimate for a pure race car is a rod end or Heim joint. Being solid, these mean that there's absolutely no compliance in the joint at all. In this case, we can see on the front of this Radical SR3, the inner bushes are actually a urethane bush. Now, that might not be too common on pure race cars, however, the Radical cars are also used as street cars. They are able to be road registered. And using a urethane bush like this provides some advantages, particularly on street use, because it tends to dull down some of the noise, vibration, and harshness that would otherwise be transferred through to the chassis via a rod end. One of the aspects that's quite unusual with the front of the Radical SR3 is the anti-rollbar arrangement. And when these cars were originally designed over 20 years ago now, the designer Nick used a linkage that runs from one side of the car to another. Now, this is unique to the Radical, and it's actually been named after the designer Nick. It's called the Nick Link. Now, the way this works is that it transfers movement from one side of the suspension to the other. And the way the anti-roll bar is essentially tuned is that to stiffen the anti-roll bar, this actually requires a larger diameter nick link to be fitted to the car. Now, the reason that the nick link was developed in the first place was to reduce the complexity of a conventional anti-roll bar mechanism and also reduce some of the rod ends and linkages that were required. And originally this was done to bring the price point of the cars down. It's actually proven to be incredibly effective, and Radical are continuing to run with this right now in 2019. Another aspect of the front end design on the Radical SR3 that's really easy to see with the bodywork off is the Ackermann steering design. Now, this is an aspect of suspension design that a lot of people don't consider, don't understand, or simply overlook. In short, the Ackermann steering is designed so that when the car turns a corner, what we actually find is that the two front wheels need to turn through different arcs. The Ackermann steering design is designed in such a way that the outer wheel and the inner wheel turn at different angles. Conventional thinking to achieve what's referred to as perfect Ackermann or 100% Ackermann, if we draw an imaginary line through the steering tie rod and the upper ball joint on both sides of the car, this line should converge at the center of the rear axle. Now, that's ideal if perhaps you're driving around a supermarket car park. However, particularly at speed, it's found that that's not always the best case. And adjusting the Ackermann to suit the particular car, as well as the speed that the car is operating at, is essential if you want to get the best performance as well as sharp steering response.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.